The beautiful thing about climate change is that it doesn't care if you believe in it or not. Any molecule that is in the atmosphere that is based on a carbon atom is part of the problem. CO2 being by far the largest of those, but all of those carbon-based molecules, they all have some effect in dealing with climate change. All right, so our atmosphere, it's about 78% nitrogen, and it's about 21% oxygen, O2, and it's about 0.9% argon, give or take, about 0.9% argon, and other trace gases. So this is our atmosphere, 78% nitrogen, 21% oxygen, less than 1% argon. That's what we breathe. So what's the problem with all this carbon dioxide? Well, how much carbon dioxide is in the atmosphere? It's about 0.0407%, give or take currently. About 0.04, that's not 4%. That's 0.04% and change of the atmosphere. 0.04% carbon dioxide, a minuscule concentration. When you look at this number, if you're thinking of the pie chart of the atmosphere, why is it hard to think that 200 years of industrialization, burning coal, burning gas, automobiles, jet planes, all of the carbon that we churn into the atmosphere every year and orders of magnitude more and more every decade, why would we think that changing that number is impossible? And why would we think that with a greenhouse gas, that minuscule changes of the concentration of which will have changes in the global temperature in the degrees would make a difference? Well, that's really the basis of climate science. It doesn't really matter for the planet what the concentration of CO2 is. Earth doesn't care what the concentration of CO2 is. In fact, it talks with its sister planet Venus all the time, and Venus doesn't complain about CO2. Venus says, yeah, hey, you know, I love CO2. The greenhouse gases, CO2, methane, carbon monoxide, all the carbon compounds, it has huge ramifications for our species because we like the planet the way that it is. We don't want it to be 2, 3, 4 degrees hotter. We like the sea levels where they are because we build our cities and our towns right up to them, so we don't want them to be higher. Yeah, so it's in our best interest to lower that number a little bit, to get it down to pre-industrial levels and pre-industrial concentrations of CO2. We have other hard choices to make.